It's currently 20 to 6 in the evening. I'm currently here at Balmaha on the shores of Loch Lomond. I'm going to be heading somewhere up that way. I'm going to try and get up to the top of Conic Hill for a wee overnight camp. Try out my new stove and try out a few other new bits and pieces that I've got. I've just done a runner from work here in my wee trusty orange Skoda. So I'm just going to try and do a wee kind of micro adventure, a wee quick overnighter, and then back down the road and into work tomorrow morning. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Should be quite fun, I think. So that's quite reassuring there. That's a sign that says I'm now leaving the camping management zone. Just been coming up through the woods. Getting a wee bit of height already, but I'm heading up there onto the open hill. So it's good to know that at least I'm legal for camping up here. You do have to be careful around about the Loch Lomond area with the camping restriction zones, which are a bit annoying, but I can kind of see why they're necessary. Yeah, just got to keep on trucking on up the path and climbing. Still plenty of daylight. Looks like the sun hasn't quite set just yet, so yeah, just keep on moving. So you can still see a bit of sun through there. Well, it's not the biggest hill in the world. It's quite a wee bit of a pull up. It's quite steep. I'm just kind of going for it, trying to keep the pace up and keep moving so I can get there before it's too dark. But yeah, it's good fun. Enjoying lots of steps on the way up. More here too. Never really ends. But yeah, hopefully not too long. I'm just coming up to what's called the Bialach Ard right now. Just means high Bialach pass, I suppose. Yeah, good path. Well made, lovely weather. You can probably hear the wind starting to pick up a wee bit as well now. It's nice and calm down at car park level. It was quite sheltered down there, I suppose, but yeah, wee bit of breeze now. Still a bit early for midge yet, I think. It's only the 22nd of March, I think. Yeah, should be good. So there we go, that's the view down over Loch Lomond. Sun setting in the background. Yeah, this is lovely. Can't beat it. And then just up there, that's the hill I'm going up. So, feels like a wee bit of a distance from here, but shouldn't be too bad, I don't think. Not too long now, I don't think. Yeah, happy days. So the view behind me is amazing. Sun's just about to go down behind the hills over there. Lovely light, lovely colours. It's been a steep old pull up, I'm giving it some effort. I'm nearly there. I think this is my last little pull up. And yeah, hopefully the views will be magic and I'll catch the sun before it finally drops down below the horizon. It's probably so windy just now you can't hear my voice. So weird and sunny you can't see my face. Are either of those things a bad thing? Well, probably not, to be honest, but yeah, loving it. Here I am. I don't think this is the real summit. I think that's it, kind of over there. But it's one of the nicest views. Only taking me half an hour to get up here, than I thought. Yeah, going to have a wee wander about, wee look around, and then find a nice spot for the tent. I think maybe out on that wee nose down there probably looks like the best spot. So I'll yeah, have a look and just enjoy it. So that's it, the last little glimpse of the sun above the horizon there, above the hills. Got my spot, it's not totally level, but you know what, it'll do. here. So yeah, I'm going to just stick the tent up while I've got enough daylight to do it. And yeah, I'm nicely out, I think. So it's brilliant up here. You can see all the way down across the Highland boundary fault there. You can sometimes see all the way to Arran from here, but it's been quite a hazy night, so I don't know if that's an option for today, but still looking. So the sun is down, the tent is up. You can probably also hear that the wind is up as well. Looks like I managed to get up before it was dark because it was acting like a kite for most of that. Yeah, I'm now going to duck inside and grab some dinner and get out of the wind, hopefully. Alright, so that's probably about 1,000 decibels quieter now. I'm inside the tent, out of the wind, it's lovely. Ah, you can probably still hear the tent flapping and blowing about, which means I'm probably going to have an interesting sleep tonight. But hopefully it won't be too bad. I'm on a wee bit of a slope. But yeah, see how we go. So this is my new Jet Boil Zip, which I really, really like. I only got it pretty recently. This is actually my first time trying it outside. I tried it in the flat and I managed to get water to boil in something like 2.5 minutes, which is a bit ridiculous. Considering before I used to be a Tranja person. I always learned with Tranjas and that was just always how I did it. So when I got this thing and saw how quickly it boiled water, I was amazed. Yeah, so I'm going to have one of these Summit to Eat chicken fried rices. See how tasty that is. I've not tried these Summit to Eats before. It's been a really, really long time since I tried any dehydrated dinners. I'll see how it goes, see how tasty it is. That's it, almost no time at all. You can see the steam coming off it now. I'm going to turn that off and do some cooking or something like that. Well, good thing I got the tent up and into it when I did, because that's the rain on. You can probably hear that in the background. So yeah, I've got my chicken fried rice here. Actually pretty tasty, pretty impressed with it. I think I maybe overdid it on the water a wee bit. I kind of misread the measuring lines on the inside of my jet boil pot. But yeah, pretty impressed with that for a first effort. Yeah, just going to scram the rest of it and yeah, see how it goes. Well, that wasn't too crap. That was surprisingly alright and fairly decent. Yeah, reasonably impressed with that. Ended up just drinking most of it, kind of like more like a soup. Like I say, slightly overdid it on the water, but hey, I'll know for next time. This is how you learn these lessons, just by trying and doing, so nice, happy enough with that. I've got some snacks back there as well that I brought up in my rucksack. With it being March as well, there are still lots of mini eggs in the supermarket, so got a big old bag of mini eggs to tan. There's a nice wee pudding, so that'll be pretty ace. Well, it's now Wednesday morning, and this is my tent up above Loch Lomond. Didn't quite get the glorious sunrise I was hoping for. I think I'm maybe just a wee bit too low down to get that nice cloud inversion. See a wee bit of the sun there behind me, just popping through the clouds a wee bit. It's very cloudy here. A few keen beans up on the hill already. You can hear a dog over there. Yeah, that's all I need to do now is just get the tent put away, and then yeah, head back and go to work, which is a bit unusual, but yeah, not bad. Worse places to wake up in the morning, or not wake up as the case may be, as I'm obviously not talking very sensibly at the moment, but yeah. Boom, and just like that, the tent is gone. Leave no trace and all that. So that's the tent away. I'm just going to head back down to the car and go to work. I think I'm going to do a wee bit of a litter pick on my way down as well. I've got a carrier bag and there's quite a lot of rubbish lying around, so I'll maybe just see what I can pick up on the way down and actually do a bit to improve it a wee bit as well. So it's not just about leaving nothing, but trying to take away whatever I can to kind of help out. So yeah, it's quite a busy hill, so yeah, I'll see what I can help to tidy up. So I just bent down to pick up a can of Monster Energy, and I found a wee clump of tadpoles. So that's gone in my rubbish bag now, and hopefully the tadpoles won't be too hyper from the Monster Energy. I'm just going to keep on carrying on and seeing what I see on the way down. Make my way down now, lots and lots of steps, lots and lots and lots and lots of steps, trying not to fall on my face. Aye, quite a lot of rubbish around, which is not very good. Lots of people left things like orange peels, toilet roll. I've kind of left a lot of the toilet roll, but I've taken some kind of wet wipes and stuff, which is not great. Yeah, quite a lot of rubbish, it's sad. Wish people wouldn't do that. That's me just coming back down to the campsite now. I don't know if you can see it at all on the camera, but a little red squirrel just ran over that tree in front of me, so that was nice. That'd cheer me up a wee bit. No end to the amount of litter I keep spotting. I've now got a pretty full carrier bag here. At least 5 bits of dog shit, which is kind of really frustrating. I'm an atheist, but if there is a hell, there should be a special place in it for people who bag their dog shit and leave it at the side of the path. Yeah, especially considering there's a big bin right there. So yeah, sorry Nevisport for the bad PR for your logo, but your bag did the business quite nicely. Alright, so back at my wee trusty orange Skoda. Yeah, that was a really, really nice wee overnighter. Quite enjoyed that. I can't wait to do that again. Yeah, it's just getting to the point where it's just into the spring now where I've got just enough daylight to do it, so it's brilliant. Would highly recommend. Nice little overnight jaunt away. And now I've just got to jump in the car, jump back to Glasgow and go to work, where I'll hopefully have time to grab a quick shower before I get started for the sake of my colleagues and other people and stuff. But yeah, nice.